Welcome to John's Guitar Lab, still under construction. It's taken a little bit of time, but by the video after this, we should be completed. All right. Today, jumping right in. Let's not look at the A chord for a minute. Okay, let's sort of pretend that that's not there. What we're going to be looking at this point is we want to see the G bar, the C bar, and the D bar. Okay? Remember in the last video we were doing 8 beats with the Remember that? Okay. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be doing 8 beats G, 8 beats C, and 8 beats D. And it's in that order. Ooh, metronome. One, and again it's in eighths. One, and two, and three, and four, and one. Then, okay, what we're doing, 8 beats G, 8 beats C, 8 beats D, another 8 beats G, then you start the sequence again. So the chord changes, okay? I'm going to be G to C to D to G. It's that G, okay? The G, and then the sequence starts again. 8, 8, 8, and 8. Okay? What this is, now we're playing it extremely slow, but if we were to play this a little bit faster, when we get a little comfortable and we could start moving those chords, okay? Here's the song, well, we won't even use the metronome this time, all right? But the song, you know it. In the left hand, okay, if I lift my fingers, I just chop the strings a little bit. Or you can let it ring. You hear the difference? Now, why I say to you, slow and let it ring, because it's much easier to release the pressure. But if you know how to play with the pressure, now you have two areas that you can work with. So let's say now we're doing old time rock and roll, okay? Now listen to something very simple we could do to add color to it. Two, three, four. Thank you. method to the madness. All right? And just to give you a little bit of a heads up, what's going to be going on later is once you master this position, master it, and what I mean by that is to get very comfortable, all right? It's going to take a little time, but we'll be able to incorporate all those little, like, groove things, like, saying that's where we're going to be heading down. Again, it just work with the metronome, work with all downs, and believe me, all this stuff, once you have that strong bass, this other stuff is not that difficult. Okay? As long as you can, you know, hold that, you know, get that bar chord. Started out like this, and as I said, okay, you always have this, the ringing, then you have this, later on you have, or you have, there's a link on the bottom for All Time Rock and Roll, not specifically the name, the song itself, but a link to where you can go and get the chords, where you'll see exactly where the chord changes, and a lot of times you'll also see the lyric, okay, so that way you know exactly where you are in the song. All right, work with this, have fun with it. All right, and as always, comments, questions, please, you know, just throw them at me. We'll help you out. Give me that thumbs up, please, and subscribe. Enjoy, and I hope, oh, I know what I forgot. Forgot to show you the can of paint. Okay, it's lighter this time, okay? And hopefully it won't be here anymore on the next video. Take care and enjoy your day.